Understand we are here from Loveland at Thompson Valley High School. As the Fort Morgan Mustangs come in with a record of 6-1 overall, 2-0 in league. The Eagles are 3-1, 1-1 in league play. And the starting lineup for the Fort Morgan Mustangs, leading off will be Briggs Wheatley, first baseman. He'll be followed up by Antonio Velasquez at catcher. Frank Ortega, third base. He'll be batting third. Cleanup today is Jesse Campa, who is pitching. Colin Farley in right field is fifth. David Keller, left field, is batting sixth. Charlie Langford, shortstop, is batting seventh. Levi McCoy, batting eighth, is in center field. And Bodie Wheatley at second base is batting ninth. Defensively for the Thompson Valley Eagles, Javier Flores in center field, Bo Heaton at second base, Kellen Schultz pitching, Jay Douglas is catching, Riley Suarez right field, Zach McVay is third base, KJ Lewis is left field, Landon Carlson is first base, and Evan Rabi is the shortstop. So Kellen Schultz getting his warm-ups taken care of. He has one left, I believe. And Briggs will step up to the plate as he bats in from the left side. Briggs on the year has only had 7 plate appearances. He does have no hits, has scored 5 runs though. And that pitch is in there, and that is going to be high for ball one. And the pitch, and that ball is going to be fouled down the first baseline. So one ball and one strike. Now to the leadoff hitter, Briggs Wheatley. Mustangs come in off of a trip down to La Junta last Thursday, last Friday and Saturday, I believe. And the pitch, and that is a fouled straight back. So now one ball and two strikes to the leadoff batter, Briggs Wheatley. Schultz with the kick and the delivery, and that ball is going to be fouled off to the left. So Briggs stays alive. Going to make Schultz throw at least one more pitch here in this opening frame. Beautiful day here in Loveland. Schultz with the pitch, and that is upstairs. Ball two, 2 balls, 2 strikes. 65 degree day here, a slight breeze. Some clouds, but beautiful baseball weather. And the pitch, and that ball is going to be popped up to shallow center field. And coming down with it out there is Javier Flores. Four out number one on that pop fly to center field. Up next is Antonio Velasquez, the catcher for the Mustangs. Batting at 235. And the pitch, and that missed just outside. 4 ball one. And the pitch, up and in again, ball two. 2 balls, no strikes to the catcher, Antonio Velasquez. And the pitch, and that is a swing and a miss. As Antonio was looking for the fence on that one, but came up empty. Antonio is a right-handed batter. And the pitch, and that's going to be nubbed to the third baseman. Yes, he comes down with it. So out number two here in the top of the first. Up now is going to be Frank Ortega, third baseman for the Mustangs. Frankie on the year is batting at 333. Yeah, Schultz looks in and gets his sign from Douglas. And that ball hit him, just grazed him was a hit by pitch, so that puts Frankie on. That will bring up Jesse Campa. Campa on the year is batting at 190. As he bats in from the right side as Schultz steps off the mound for a minute, now back up, gets his sign from Douglas, looks over at Frank. Frank with his lead, and that pitch is going to be there for a strike. So no balls and one strike to the cleanup hitter, Jesse Campa. Schultz checks the runner and the pitch, and that's going to be hit down the left field line, but that's going to be well foul. No balls, two strikes, two outs. Briggs Wheatley popped out to center. Antonio Velasquez popped up to the third baseman. Frank Ortega was hit by a pitch. And that brings up Jesse Campa here. In the top of the first inning here from Loveland. Throw over, back safely is Frankie. Schultz looks in, gets his sign from Jay Douglas. Checks Frankie over at first, comes home, and that ball is going to be popped, but out of play off to the left. So the count still stands at no balls and two strikes as a home plate umpire cleans off home plate. Mustangs will be home tomorrow to this same Thompson Valley team. It'll be a 4 o'clock start at Fort Morgan. Schultz goes over, but back in safely, just barely, is Frank Ortega. It's a nice throw over. Frankie's still alive over there at first. No score here in the top of one. Frankie takes off, and that's going to be a swing and a miss. And they're going to throw him out at first. So no runs, no hits, no errors. We go to the bottom of the first inning here on Morgan County's B106 in the Eastern Plains Sports Network. Now to the bottom of the first inning as the Thompson Valley Eagles come to the plate. It is Jesse Campa on the hill this afternoon for the Mustangs. He is 2-0 on the year with a 2.44 ERA in three appearances. Leading off for the Thompson Valley Eagles will be Javier Flores, center fielder, followed by Bo Heaton, second baseman. Third is Kellen Schultz, pitcher. Cleanup is Jay Douglas at catcher. The fifth batter is Riley Suarez. He's the right fielder. Sixth in the lineup is Zach McBay. He's playing third base. Seventh is KJ Lewis, left field. Landon Carlson at first base is batting eighth. And Evan Rabe is batting ninth. He is the shortstop. So does Javier Flores as he bats in from the right side. Jesse Campa on the hill and the pitch. And that breaking ball is in there for a strike. This umpire has a very slow strike call. And the pitch, that's going to be hit right back up the middle. Out to Charlie Lankford and over to first. And on the tag, he is out. Pulled Briggs off a little bit. But Briggs got him on the tag on the ground out. 6-3. So Bo Heaton, second baseman, he bats in from the right side. Nice job there by Charlie Lankford to flag that down out at the second base spot. That pitch misses up for ball one. One ball and no strikes. No score here in the bottom of the first. That pitch on the outside corner is in there for a strike. Nice fastball there by Jesse Campa. And the pitch, and that's going to be low and outside. Ball two, two balls and one strike to Bo Heaton. And the pitch, and that's going to be in the dirt. Three balls and one strike. He's got to come in with it here to Heaton. Campa with the delivery, and that's going to be hit right back up the middle. That's going to be a slow roller to Langford. First hustle over. Nice job to hustle that in for Langford. I thought maybe it was going to be an infield hit as slow as that was hit. Charlie with the hustle and the nice throw over to first base for out number two. That'll bring up Kellen Schultz, pitcher for the Eagles here today. Two up, two down. And no score here at Thompson Valley High School. Jesse shakes off a couple of signs, gets one he likes, and the pitch. And that is in there for a strike. No balls, one strike to Kellen Schultz, the pitcher. He had 16 total pitches. And that pitch is going to be hit foul off to the right and well out of play. So no balls, two strikes. Campa ahead in the count here. With two outs. On deck is catcher Jay Douglas. Campa with the pitch, and that's going to be hit out into right field. Out to Colin Farley as he'll hustle it back in. The first hit of the day goes to the Thompson Valley Eagle. Let's see if we can see who this runner is. It's going to be a courtesy runner. It's going to be Garrett Hendrickson. So Hendrickson now batting for Kellen Schultz. So Jay Douglas up to the bat here now. One on, two outs. Going to throw over. That was close. Got him. Nice pickoff there by Jesse Campa. Yes. Garrett Hendrickson wandered off the base too far. So the Thompson Valley Eagles get one run, no hits though, or one hit, no runs. As we go to the top of two here on Morgan County's B106 in the Eastern Plains Sports Network. To the top of two we go here. It'll be lead off by Colin Farley, then he'll be followed by David Keller, and then Charlie Langford. Colin Farley, right fielder today. So Farley on the year is batting at 222. Schultz up on the mound gets his signal from Jay Douglas. And the pitch, and that is a swing and a miss. It was an off-speed pitch. And Farley was way out ahead of that pitch. So no balls and one strike to the number five hitter, Colin Farley. And the pitch, and that is another swing and a miss. Colin is completely fooled right now by those pitches that Schultz has thrown. And Schultz gets his sign, one he likes, and the pitch, and that one is inside for ball one. One ball, two strikes. So we will see if he goes back outside where he got those first two. And the pitch, and that is a swing and a miss. Farley goes down swinging here for out number one here on the top of the second. That'll bring up David Keller, left fielder for the Mustangs. Keller on the year is batting at 250. Schultz. And that ball is going to be fouled back to the screen. Four strike one. Mustangs come in eighth in the ranks in Chassa, or not RPI, but just in the rankings. That pitch swung on and missed as they are eighth in the rankings. And the pitch, and that is going to be chopped foul down the third base line. So no balls, two strikes. To David Keller. Schultz so far, 23 pitches, 17 strikes, six balls. And the pitch, and that's going to be hit out into left field. He's going to be able to run because the left fielder was played way over to center field. Yep. Keller is going to stay at second with a double. Nice job there by David Keller as he pulled that down. They were playing him to go more to right field. First hit of the game for the Mustangs is David Keller. Sitting out there at second base with two outs. One out, excuse me. It is Charlie Langford. And the pitch. And that ball is going to be cued off to the out into right field. They're going to hold him up at third. They're going to keep Keller at third. So a nice single there by Charlie Langford. He went opposite way. So now runners at the corners. Keller over at third. And Langford at first after that hit. So back-to-back hits here for the Mustangs. As it will now be Levi McCoy. So you can just put it in play here. With one out. Over to first. But back safely is Langford. The low throw almost threw it away down the first baseline. If that happens, Keller will come in. We'll see if Langford is on the move with Keller over at third. Not right now. And that pitch is going to be low in the dirt. One ball, no strikes is Levi McCoy looks down third base, gets his signal from Josh Langford. Schultz checks these runners, checks third, and comes home, and that ball is going to be fouled back out of play. So that evens it up at one ball and one strike with one out here in the top of two. Mustangs with two on. Keller over at third, Langford on at first. Keller with a double, Langford with a single. Now back over to first, back safely and easily is Langford. So they got him worried over there. I've seen the Mustangs do this before where they'll send somebody from first when they have a runner at third. Langford is going and that ball is going to be popped up on the infield. He needs to get back, and he does. And for the second out here in the top of, or the bottom, the top of the second, excuse me, as that shortstop comes down with it. Everybody held their positions. Langford had to get back. So it now be Bodie Wheatley, second baseman, up at the plate. See if he can get one in. And that pitch is in there for a strike. And then the delayed steal by Langford. So now two runners in scoring position. We'll see if Bodie can get him in here. Schultz with the pitch, and that ball is going to be hit right back up the middle to the shortstop over to first, and out at first will be Bodie Wheatley. So no runs on two hits. We'll go to the bottom of the two here on Morgan County's B106 and the Eastern Plains Sports Network. So the bottom of two we go here. The Mustangs threaten in the top of the second inning, but do not score. David Keller with a double. Langford with the single. Langford then stole second, but could not come in as McCoy and Wheatley both out And the pitch. And that pitch is in there for strike one. Jay Douglas catching here for the Eagles here this afternoon at the plate. And that ball is going to be smoked out to left field, right between third and short. So their second hit of the game. With no outs here, they'll have a courtesy runner, it looks like. And we'll see who this is going to be. Everything, it's hard to see, but the, everything is, I believe it's number one on the courtesy runner, and that will be Trevor Windisch. He's batting for Jay Douglas. Up the bat now is Riley Suarez, right fielder. As he bats in from the right side, so a runner on first. That is Trevor Windisch as the courtesy runner. And he's taken off. Throw down, and that's going to be to the left field side. And in safely is Windisch. On the stolen base, so runner now at second in scoring position with no outs. And that pitch was a strike. No balls and one strike. And the pitch, and that is a big swing and a miss there by Riley Suarez. No balls, two strikes with one on. Campa looks back out at second, and the pitch. That was a little low and outside. One ball, two strikes. That pitch was close, but it was a little low. As Campa looks in to Velasquez. And the pitch, and that's going to be chopped out to the shortstop. Nice throw over, and out at first is Riley Suarez. Nice job out there by Charlie Langford. So 6-3 on the play. The runner does move up to third now with one out. Yes, Campa looks in. And the pitch, and that ball is going to be chopped, and that's going to be a fair ball down the third baseline. So that will score Windisch.
Nice try, Frank.
So a single down the third baseline. That puts the Eagles up now 1-0 here in the bottom of the second. That will bring up KJ Lewis, a left fielder. So a run in, throw over. The back safely is Zach McVeigh. He was a third baseman. He got that single down the third base line. Campbell looks in, and the pitch, and that's going to be a swing and a miss. No balls, one strike to the number seven hitter, KJ Lewis. Right-handed batter. Scampa looks over at first and comes home, and that pitch is outside for ball one. One ball, one strike with one out here in the bottom of inning number two. As Scampa looks in to Velasquez, is going to be throw over, but back in safely once again is Zach McVeigh. Briggs Wheatley over at first today. Bodie Wheatley at second, Frankie at third, Charlie Langford at short. And the pitch, runner is going. That's going to be to Langford. There is one, and double play. Nice job there by the Mustangs. But Thompson Valley does score. They get one run on two hits. And we'll go to the top of the third inning. Thompson Valley up 1-0 here on Morgan County's B106 and the Eastern Plains Sports Network. Well, Mustangs down now 1-0 after Thompson Valley put one on the board here in the bottom of two. Up to the plate now will be Briggs Wheatley as they have come back around to the top of the lineup. And that pitch is going to be smack foul down the right field line. He got into that, but just foul. So Kellen Schultz pitching today is 1-0 with a 3.94 ERA. Balls and one strike to Briggs, and that ball is going to be fouled back to the fence. Briggs down now in the count. No balls, two strikes here in the top of the third inning. A few clouds around. Hopefully they will stay away. And the pitch, and that is going to be hit between second or between third and short for a single for Briggs. So Briggs leads it off here in the top of the third with a hit. He will be followed here now by Velasquez. He, struck out his first time up. See if they, what they have on here. If they're going to send Briggs or they're going to let Antonio take a couple three pitches as Schultz looks back. That ball is going to be nubbed to the third baseman. And they're going to go to first for the out. But that did move. Briggs to second. But now with one out. Frank Ortega hit by a pitch his first time up. As they try to sneak in behind Briggs. And the pitch. And that ball is going to be... takes a bad hop, and that goes out to the left fielder, and they're going to bring Briggs home. Nice job there on that single by Frank Ortega as that ties it up here at one. But took a bad bounce out there. Looked like the third baseman was going to be able to come up with it, and he bobbled it a little bit, but Frank did not advance. He got to first. It's all tied up here at one now. Jesse Campa at the plate. He is 0 for 1. That ball is going to be hit out to the second baseman on the pop-up. So Jesse out on one pitch. So Frankie's still at first over there. They're still at first. As the Mustangs tie it up here in the top of the third, 1-1. Colin Farley grounds back to the pitcher, hands it off to the first baseman for out number three. So the Mustangs with a run here on one hit as we go to the bottom of the third inning. The Mustangs have tied it up here all at one here on Morgan County's B106 and the Eastern Plains Sports Network. To the bottom of inning number three we go here as the Mustangs have tied it up here all at one. The Mustangs need to get that one run on two hits, no errors, and one left on. So Landon Carlson at the plate, first baseman. Jesse with a pitch, and it pitches in there for a strike. Catches the outside part of the plate, I believe, or off to the right a little bit, so it's tough to tell. But Campa with a pitch, and that pitch is apparently outside. Evens it up here at one. One ball and one strike. As Campa looks in, gets his sign here in the bottom of the third inning, all tied up at one. And the pitch is going to be low and away. Ball two. Two balls and one strike. Greg Mullen, State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Greg Mullen and his team are there to make the insurance world easy for you. Call them today, 842-4555. And the pitch. And that curveball is in there for a strike. Two balls, two strikes to the number eight batter, Landon Carlson. That's in from the right side. Campa likes what he sees. And the pitch. And that is going to be hit to Frankie at third. Bobbles it a minute over to Briggs for the out. Nice job there by Frank. For out number one. Here in the bottom of inning number three. So that will now bring up Evan Robbie. The shortstop, he bats from the left side. So nobody on with one out here in the bottom of three. Campa gets his sign and the delivery, and that's going to be up and away for ball one. This is Robbie's first time up to the plate today here in the bottom of the third. And pitch is going to be hit out to right field. And Colin Farley could not come down with it. He kept going back and going back. Now they're going to try and get him at third, but he is in with a triple. So Evan Robbie. Triples over the head of Colin Farley out in right field. So now one on and one out. And that will bring up Javier Flores. He grounded out his first time up. As Campa with the pitch, and that off-speed pitch is in there for a strike. Mustangs do have one out. Javier Flores will try to get it in play, and that is going to be fouled straight back. So no balls, two strikes. Jesse gets ahead in the count. Here on Javier Flores, he grounded out his first time up. Be nice to get a strike out here. Keep that runner at third with one out. Jesse with the pitch, and that's going to be hit right back to the pitcher. Comes down with it, goes to first, as Jesse looked to third and held that runner over at third. So now two out. Nice job there by Jesse Campa to field his position. Hit right back to him. Looked the runner back to third and went to first to Wheatley and got the out for out number two. And that pitch is in there for a strike. Takes a little bit for this umpire to ring up the batter. Campa with the delivery, and that ball is going to be popped up on the infield. Looks like to Briggs Wheatley, and he comes down with it for out number three. So Thompson Valley threatens off a triple, but do not score. So we'll go to the top of four, all knotted up here at one on Morgan County's B106 and the Eastern Plains Sports Network. To the top of four we go here, all knotted up here at one. As Thompson Valley threatened in the bottom of the third with a triple, but did not score him. Nice job on the Mustangs getting those two outs. David Keller up at the plate now. He doubled his first time up, and that ball is hit out down the right field line, but it's going to go well foul. So Keller behind in the count now. No balls and one strike. Got some clouds poking around here under high cloudy conditions right now. And the pitch, and that is going to be hit out into center field, and that will drop for Keller. So he is two for two here this afternoon. As he gets that single out into left center field. And I will bring up Charlie Langford. He singled his first time up. Keller with the lead. That's going to be right back up the middle. Nice stop out there by the shortstop for one. But they do get the lead runner.
around.
Put it in play. Now just one on as David Keller out with one out. Up at the plate now is Levi McCoy. And he's going to foul it down the third base line. Levi flied out his first time up. Schultz waits for Levi to get back into the box. Levi was looking down at Coach Langford for a sign, and Coach said just hit away. Going to throw back over to first, but Charlie's back in well ahead of the tag. Once again, Levi McCoy up to hit the ball, and that ball is in the dirt. Nice job there by the catcher, Jay Douglas, as he prevented Langford from going on to second base. One ball, one strike, one out, 1-1 here in the top of the fourth. And that pitch is on the inside corner for strike two. One ball and two strikes. To center fielder Levi McCoy, who flied out his first time up. Bats in from the right side, and the pitch, and that is in the dirt once again, but stopped by Douglas. Two balls, two strikes. Yeah, Schultz looks into Douglas for the sign, likes what he sees, checks the runner. The runner goes, and that's going to be outside and no throw, as Douglas could not handle that outside pitch. But Langford, 2 seconds on the stolen base. So full count here, 3 balls, 2 strikes. With one out, Mustangs have one in scoring position. That ball is going to be caught right at the shortstop. Nice job out there by Evan Robbie. So Charlie Langford held up at second base. Now 2 outs. Bodie Wheatley up at the plate. He grounded out his first time up. Langford gets his lead, and that ball is going to be popped up on the infield to the shortstop. So the Mustangs do not score here in the top of the fourth inning. We will go to the bottom of the fourth inning with it all tied up here on Morgan County's B106 and the Eastern Plains Sports Network. 1-1 here as we go to the bottom of the fourth inning. Kellen Schultz will lead off for the Eagles. He'll be followed by Jay Douglas, then Riley Suarez. Schultz had a single to right field his first time up. Yes, Campa checks, make sure his defense is set where they want him, where he would like them. Yes, Schultz bats in from the right side. And Campa with the pitch, and that's gonna be low and outside. Is that skips by Velasquez to the backstop. So 1-0 here in the bottom of the fourth inning. And the pitch, and that is up and in for ball two. 2 balls, 0 strikes to the leadoff hitter, Kellen Schultz. Campus so far with 34 total pitches here. Start off this fourth inning, and that pitch is going to be fouled back. Like a little off-speed pitch there that Schultz was just under. As Velasquez retrieved that foul ball, and usually it's the on-deck hitter that comes and gets that, but did not do that this time. So Schultz with the pitch, and that is going to be upstairs. Three balls and one strike. To Kellen Schultz, who singled his first time up. And the pitch, and that is going to be popped up here. It looks like Bodie Wheatley is going to, no, it was Briggs that came down with it. Just up by, off the dirt. There behind first base. So one down now here in the bottom of four. And that will bring up Jay Douglas, the catcher. He singled his first time up. Singled out to left field. As they're retrieving something that came over the fence down in right field. Not sure just what that all was, but Colin Farley now back in position. The Jesse Camp up on the hill, 37 pitches so far. Nice job by Jesse. That pitch is going to be popped up down the third baseline. We'll see if anybody can get to it. Looks like Keller might get to it. No, it's going to be over the extended fence down there and out of play. But nice job, hustle there by David Keller and Frank Ortega to try to get that ball, but it did go out of play. So Frankie picks up his hat as he gets back into his position there at third base. Keller back into his position out in left. Campa back up on the hill to get his sign. And the pitch. Must have been outside for ball one. One ball, one strike to Jay Douglas. One out here in the bottom of four, 1-1. And that pitch is going to be low and away for ball two. Two balls, one strike. Campa steps off the mound for a minute. Now back up. And the pitch. And that's going to be out to the second baseman, or out to the shortstop, excuse me. A bad hop. We're going to go ahead and give him a hit on that. That just took a bad hop out there on Langford. So that'll put one on now. Jay Douglas, Riley Suarez grounded out his first time up. Now they're going to have a courtesy runner once again. And it will be Trevor Windisch. Clouds getting a little thicker off to the west and northwest. As Campa checks Windisch over at first. Windisch got to steal his first time up. Throw over Windisch's back safely. Riley Suarez grounded out to the shortstop. His first time up. And the pitch. And that is in there for a strike. No balls, one strike, one out. Bottom of four with one on. And the pitch. And that ball is hit out to right field, out to Farley. Farley comes in. Comes down with the out. A nice job there by Farley for out number two. As the runner held up at first. So Zach McVay now up to the plate. Singled his first time up down the third base line. Now with two outs. We'll see if they send Windisch. The Campa with the look in, and that's going to be hit right back up the middle. And that will send, well, that'll send Windisch as it was misplayed out in center field. And over to third. That should have been a single, but that was misplayed. Out in center field. He ends up at third. Does Zach McVay. So that makes it now 2-1. Yes, Levi McCoy let that one skip by him. So KJ Lewis up the plate now with two outs and the pitch. And that is going to be fouled back. No balls and one strike to KJ Lewis, left fielder for the Eagles here this afternoon. Camp with 45 total pitches, but do have two outs. And the pitch, and that is going to be fouled back. So Zach McVay over at third. After he hit a single, and then McCoy misplayed it out in center field, let it get by him. So Campa with the pitch, and that's going to be hit to Langford. Langford with the throw over, and not a good throw. That was deep in the hole, but that will score the run. Puts Thompson Valley up now 3-1. So in play. Running now out at second. It's KJ Lewis. Eagles now up 3-1. And that pitch is going to be fouled out of play. Thompson Valley puts two on the board here so far here in the bottom of the fourth inning. As the wind starts to kick up from the south. Campbell looks back in the pitch, and that is a swing and a miss on that off-speed pitch. No balls now and two strikes to Landon Carlson, who grounded out his first time up. So runner out at second and the pitch. And that pitch is going to be up for ball one. One ball, two strikes. As Campbell now sitting at 50 pitches. As he looks in, gets his sign from Velasquez. And the pitch. Oh, nice. And Velasquez was wondering where that pitch was, but it must have been outside. So now two balls and two strikes.
Nice pitch.
As Campa back up on the mound, back in the batter's box is Carlson. And the pitch, and that is going to be up and in. For ball three, three balls, two strikes. Campa needs to settle down. As he steps off for a minute, now back up on the pitching rubber. Looks in, likes what he sees. No, he's going to step back off a minute. Now back up on the mound. Looks in, gets his sign from Velasquez. Likes what he sees. Runner gets his lead out at second. And the pitch, and that is going to be ball four, blowing away. So now two on. Evan Robbie, shortstop, up at the plate now. He tripled his first time up out to Colin Farley, out to left field, out to right field, excuse me, as it went over his head. Yes, Coach Langford is going to take a trip out to the mound and have a chat with the infield. With two runners on here, Landon Carlson gets on via the walk. KJ Lewis out at second after the throwing error by Langford from shortstop. So it is Evan Robbie up at the plate now as Coach Langford finds his way back to the dugout. As I said before, he tripled his first time up over the head of Farley out in right field. And the pitch, and that is going to be hit out to right field once again, but looks like Farley is under it. And he does come down with the out in right field. So in that half of the inning, the Eagles get two runs on two hits, two errors, and two left on. We'll go to the top of the fifth with the Mustangs now behind by 2-3-1 here on Morgan County's B106 and the Eastern Plains Sports Network. Okay, to the top of the fifth inning we go here. Mustangs, see if they can work on getting a couple runs here. Getting one run here is Mustangs now down 3-1. Thompson Valley with 3 runs, 6 hits in, 3 left on. I have the Mustangs with 1 run on 6 hits, 2 errors, and 5 left on. Leadoff batter will be the leadoff hitter, Briggs Wheatley. He is 1-for-2. He had flied out his first time and then singled to left field his second time up. So 3-1 here, top of 5. As Thompson Valley gets set here to pitch to Briggs Wheatley. Kellen Schultz still on the hill for the Eagles, and that pitch looked inside, but they're going to give him the strike. It'll be Wheatley, Velasquez, and Ortega, and the pitch, and that is inside by the catcher to the backstop.
Watch your lips.
As Briggs had to back away from that pitch. Briggs back in, and the pitch, and that is a swing and a miss. Strike 2, 1 ball and 2 strikes to the leadoff hitter, Briggs Wheatley. Mustangs down 3-1 here as we play in the top of 5. And the pitch, and that is going to be chopped down to the first baseman. He's going to get it over to the pitcher covering. So Briggs will be out on the ground out. Three to one. That will bring up Antonio Velasquez. He'll be followed up by Frank Ortega. Antonio is 0-for-2. He struck out and grounded out to the third baseman, and that is going to be fouled off of his foot. Goes out into fair territory, but that is a foul ball. Antonio's going to walk it off here a minute as Coach Langford comes in to talk to him. Buildings by Design, when it comes to experience, Buildings by Design is the best in the business. Quality, commitment, and experience makes Buildings by Design the only choice when it comes to your next project. So Antonio back in the batter's box, and the pitch, and that is a swing and a miss. Now down on the count, no balls, 2 strikes. He steps out a minute, listens to Coach Langford. Now back in as Schultz with pitch number 54. And that is going to be nubbed out to the second baseman. Comes up with it. Over to first to Carlson for the out. So ground out 4-3. We'll see if Frankie can get things started here as he is 1-for-1. He was hit by a pitch his first time up and then singled out to left field. Mustangs will play this same team tomorrow at home. This game was supposed to have been on Tuesday, but rained out. And the pitch, and that is a swing and a miss on that off-speed pitch from Schultz. As Frankie gets back in the batter's box, behind in the count, no balls and 1 strike. Schultz with the kick and the delivery, and that is high for ball 1. 1 ball, 1 strike. Mustangs with their 1 lone run in the third. And the pitch, and that is a swing and a miss on that fastball. Thompson Valley scored 1 run the bottom of the second. Mustangs countered with that in the top of the third. Then in the bottom of the fourth, the Eagles put 2 on the board, and that pitch is low as that gets past the catcher to the backstop. Not sure we have, don't have a different pitcher out there. Looks like it may be. Have to see if I can see who that is. Might be Jay Douglas on the mound. And the pitch, and that is going to be low and away. For ball three, three balls, two strikes. And I believe that is Jay Douglas now out on the mound. And the pitch, and that is upstairs for ball four. So Frank gets the walk. That'll start it off here. We'll get Jesse up here. He is 0 for 2. Just throw it out at first on a drop third strike and then fly it out to the second baseman. So one on here with two outs. Frank over at first and the pitch. And that is going to be fouled back. He was on it just under it a little bit. Josh Langford with the signs. Jesse back in at the plate. As the pitcher checks his runner over at first, Frankie goes, that pitch is up. And Frankie will be in there with a stolen base.
All right, Jesse, there he is.
So got one now in scoring position. Ball and one strike, and the pitch. He held up. Two balls and one strike to Campa. Frankie out at second base, got a walk, and then stole second. Schultz checks the runner, and that is going to be a swing and a miss. For strike two, two balls, two strikes. Need to try and get it in play. You never know what happens putting it in play. Make him handle that ball, might make an error. But 3-1 Eagles as we play here in the top of the fifth. And the pitch, and that is going to be tomahawked out to left field and over the head of the left fielder. So that will bring in Ortega on the double. Looked like that Campa was going to be able to, was going to end up being out. But hit over the head of KJ Lewis. Now we'll have a courtesy runner out there for Campa. That will be Joseph Layden. But Campa with the double. As Colin Farley steps into the plate, he is 0 for 2, a ground out and a strikeout. Joseph Layden out there at second. And that pitch is going to be up and away. For ball one, now score is 3-2 as Frankie scored on that double by Campa. And the pitch, and that is a swing and a miss. By Farley out in front of that pitch. That's Farley. Digs in, they look back to Layton and the pitch. That is going to be upstairs. Two balls and one strike. See if Farley can. Get a hit here and get Layton in. And that is a swing and a miss. Evens the count now. Two balls and two strikes. And that is Jay Douglas. It is out on the mound. I can't tell who the catcher is right now. Can't see the number because of the chest protector hookup. And the pitch. And that is going to be upstairs for ball three. Three balls, two strikes. With two out. Mustangs down 1-3-2 as the Mustangs score Frankie on a double by Jesse Campa. And the pitch, and that is going to be swing and a miss, four strike three. So the Mustangs do get one run on one hit, one left. We go to the bottom of five. The Eagles lead it now 3-2 here on Morgan County's B106 and the Eastern Plains Sports Network. To the bottom of the fifth inning we go as the Mustangs down 1-3-2. Let's see, I think we have a new batter here, if I can see a number. It's supposed to be Javier Flores, and it could be. I can't, they don't have any numbers on the front. We got a bat just outside of the dugout there on the Morgan side, trying to get it back in. I believe it is Javier Flores, the center fielder. He is 0 for 2 on two ground outs. First one to Langford and the second one to Campa. And the pitch. And that is going to be fouled off to the left to the third base dugout. It is Javier Flores. He'll be followed by Bo Heaton and then Kellen Schultz. If Schultz is still in, I'm not sure. Let's see here. I believe he still is. Campa with a signal. And the pitch. And that is going to be outside. Ball one. One ball, one strike. To the leadoff batter, Javier Flores, 0 for 2. And the pitch. And that is going to be in the dirt. Campa overthrowing that one. So two balls and one strike from Campa. And the pitch, and that is going to be hit out to left field, and that will drop in front of David Keller. So Flores will start it off with a single. He will be followed by Bo Heaton and Kellen Schultz on deck. So one on. No outs here in the bottom of the fifth inning as Flores gets on with a single out to left. As they finally shut the walk-up music off. Throw over to first. But just back safely is Flores. Briggs holding Flores on. Campa, his time is called at the plate. Bo Heaton calls time and they allow it. Now back in at the plate. Yes, Campa with the pitch, and that ball is going to be hit out into right field. And it is going to drop. It did fall in fair. I couldn't quite see where it hit there, but it did fall in fair for a single. Runners at first and second with no outs here in the bottom of the fifth. And Kellen Schultz up to the plate. He is 1 for 2, singled his first time up and then flied out to Wheatley his last time up. Campa with the pitch, and that's going to be low. Gets away from him, but not far enough to let the runners advance. One ball, no strikes to the number three hitter, Kellen Schultz. Campa looks back, and the runners are going to go, and they're going to go to third, but in safely as the ball gets away from Ortega. But the double steal. As that puts two runners in scoring position now. Here with no outs here in the bottom of the fifth with the Eagles leading at 3-2. Flores at third, Heaton out at second. Kellen Schultz, and nice stop there by Velasquez. Now three balls and no strike. Campa with a pitch, and that is going to be chopped out to, oh, it's going to get by. That's an error as Briggs goes out, and so that will score two. As that was misplayed there, I don't know if that was by, we'll just have to give him a single on that. As two come in, it was misplayed. As Briggs went for it, and then Bodie went for it. And Bodie, and then it kind of skipped off to the left. Now that's going to be off of the, so Schultz is going to end up at second on that pass ball. So not good clean baseball here by the Mustangs whatsoever, as they are down now 5-2. And Schultz at it. Second base still with no outs. And the pitch, and that is a swing and a miss. As that evens the count at 1-1. To Jay Douglas. Campbell looks back. And time is going to be called at the plate. Campa taking too much time here, and Jet Douglas backs out. Douglas back in at the plate, and the pitch, and that ball is hit hard out to center field, and that ball may be gone. And that is a two-run home run for Jay Douglas. He hit that out over the center field fence. And that will now make the score 7-2, as Eagles have put four on the board here in the bottom of the fifth inning. So the Mustangs, when they come up to bat next, will have some work to do. Riley Suarez at the plate now. He is 0 for 2. He grounded out and flied out. Campa with 66 total pitches, 43 strikes, 23 balls. He just gave up that 365-foot home run to Jay Douglas. That first pitch is in the dirt for ball one. 1-0. Yes, Campa looks into Velasquez. And the pitch, and that is in there for a strike. 1-1, and the pitch, and that missed low and away. 2-1 to the number 5 hitter, Riley Suarez. And the pitch, and that is a swing and a miss on that pitch, low and away. Mustangs at 2-0 in league. And the pitch, and that is a swing and a miss for strike three. Finally one out here in the bottom of the fifth. And that will bring up Zach McVay. Third baseman for the Eagles, nobody on. But four have come in here in this fifth inning for the Eagles. That pitch is outside for ball one. 1-0. And the pitch, and that one caught the outside part of the plate. That evens it up here at 1-1 with one out. Campbell looks in. And the pitch, and that is a swing and a miss on that fastball. Located nicely on the outside part of the plate. It's 1-2. Campa with the pitch, and that ball is going to be popped up and out of play behind us. I'm trying to make sure it wasn't going to be out of play and on my head, but went off behind us into somebody's yard. So one ball, two strikes, and that ball is going to be hit out to center field, out to McCoy. McCoy runs in, and finally comes down with it. Nice job out there by Levi McCoy. To come down with that ball, he had a long run from center field. He did catch up to it. Now it'll be KJ Lewis. He is 0-for-2, grounded out, and then reached on an error. And the pitch, and that ball is going to be hit out into left field. Out into right field, excuse me. For a single. So A.J. Lewis now on. That will bring up Landon Carlson. First baseman here for the Eagles. The Eagles lead at 7-2 here, bottom of the fifth. They've scored four here in the bottom of the fifth after the Mustangs put one on the board. Throw over to first, but back safely is Lewis. As Campa looks in, Lewis gets his lead over it. First base and the pitch. Must have been up, I guess. I couldn't really look like it was over the plate, but must have been up. One ball here on Landon Carlson. Throw over, but back safely is Lewis. Campa's pickoff attempts are a little high. They did get one earlier in the game, though. And the pitch, and that hit the batter. So that will move Lewis down to second. And that will bring up Evan Robbie, his shortstop. He is 1-for-2. He tripled his first time up over the head of Colin Farley out in right field, and then flied out to Farley. Farley backed up a little bit again here as we have runners at first and second. And that pitch upstairs. But there are two outs, but four in. As Evan Robbie at the plate, heading the count, one ball and no strikes, and Campa's going to step off. And now back on, looks the sign from Velasquez. As runners with their lead, they're going to throw over to first. And got him for the third out. Nice job there. Briggs was playing behind. So a pickoff. So that will give us out number three. So in that inning, had four runs, five hits, no errors, and one left. We'll go to the top of inning number six as the Mustangs are down 7-2 on Morgan County's B106 and the Eastern Plains Sports Network. Top of the sixth here as David Keller steps in, and that ball is going to be fouled back out of play once again. And it is Jay Douglas out on the mound for the Eagles. He was catching. I still cannot catch a number on the catcher. And the pitch. That is up and away for ball one. One ball, one strike. The Mustangs have work to do here as they're down 7-2. Eagles put four on the board in the fifth. And that ball is going to be hit back up the middle. Nice job there by David Keller. Get that single right back up the middle. He hit that right out to center field. Now it will be Charlie Langford up at the plate. He is 2-for-2, two singles. As Keller gets his lead over it first. And the pitch, and that ball is tomahawked down the right field line, and that will be out number one here in the sixth inning. That was caught out there by Riley Suarez. Now Levi McCoy at the plate. He is 0-for-2, a flyout and then a line drive out. And throw over to first, but back safely as Keller is the first baseman. Lost sight of the ball for a minute, but he just couldn't locate it. It was about 5 feet away from him, so Keller David Keller not going anywhere. And the pitch. And that is in there for a strike. No balls, one strike. To the eighth place hitter, Levi McCoy. He'll be followed by Bodie Wheatley. Looks like they may have a... That pitch is low. There's the pitcher with the pitch, and that is... low. It's like Luke Wolf in the on deck circle. So two balls and one strike here to Levi McCoy with David Keller on at first with one out. And that is going to be chopped foul back to the screen. Evens the count now at two apiece. Oh, that is Braden Fajardo in the on-deck circle. And the pitch, and that's going to be chopped down to the third baseman. Gloves it over to first, but the wild throw out to... Keller's got to get down, but he's going to end up being thrown out at third base as the right fielder came in. And threw Keller out. He was hesitant about... going to third. Levi McCoy that's going to be Braden Fajardo. At the plate
hit a hard break
as
let's go break.
Fajardo up for his first time up, but throwed out at third base was David Keller. He rounded second, and then hesitated, and the right fielder came in. It was a hit to the third baseman as he overthrew the second baseman, but the right fielder came in and threw Keller out at first. And that ball is going to be popped up out of play.
Quick bat. Let's go. Quick hands.
So that would have been an error on the third baseman, McVeigh.
Right through it.
There's Jay Douglas on the bump here for the Eagles for his second inning with the Mustangs down 7-2. And that pitch is going to be low and away. They're going to throw back to first, but back safely is McCoy. So two balls and one strike here to Braden Fajardo, his first time up here this afternoon. With two outs, runner at first, and that pitch is outside. So three balls, one strike. With Levi McCoy on at first. As Jay Douglas checks his runner over at first. And the pitch, and that's going to be low, ball four. So that will bring up Briggs Wheatley. He is 1-for-3. Flight out to center field and singled to left field and then grounded out to the first baseman. Now a mound visit here. Let's see if he's going to change or he's just going to have a little talk with him. Equitable Savings and Loan. Mobile banking on the go makes banking easier for you when you're on the go. Check it out today. So it looks like they are just going to have a chat out there. They're going to leave Jay Douglas on the mound. coach for the Eagles walks back to the dugout. And Briggs Wheatley steps into the plate. Into the batter's box from the left side. See if the Mustangs can make some inroads here with two outs. And the pitch, that's going to be upstairs for ball one. One ball, no strikes. McCoy on via an error by the third baseman. And then Fajardo walked. And the pitch, and that is going to be fouled down the first baseline. Evens the count out here at one ball and one strike here in the top of inning number six. Cloudy skies here now in Loveland. Briggs digs in, and the pitch. And that is low, ball two, two balls and one strike. As the catcher tried to frame that pitch, bring it up a little bit. The umpire said, no, it was low. See if Briggs can get into one here. And the pitch, and that is going to be hit out into right field. In front of Briggs Wheatley, and he will get to second on a double. Yes, he hit that down the right field line. And that will put Fajardo over at third and Wheatley out at second. And now it will be Antonio Velasquez. He is 0 for 3, a strikeout and two groundouts. So the Mustangs get one, 7-3 here. And the pitch. And that's going to be outside for ball one. They just need to wait on him. They need base runners. As Fajardo got on via the walk and then was advanced to third on a double by Briggs. And the pitch, and that's going to be upstairs. Ball two, two balls, no strikes. On deck is Frank Ortega. That's the guy you want up. Yeah, if Antonio can get on, he should be taken here. Down, or ahead in the count. Two balls and no strikes. With two on, and that pitch is going to be low in the dirt. So three balls and no strikes. We'll see how long they continue here with Jay Douglas. See if this might be his last batter here. Douglas with the pitch. And that pitch is in there for a strike. So three balls, one strike. Antonio will be taking one more time. As we are here in the top of the inning. Inning number six. And the pitch. That is low and in for ball four. So that loads the bases up for Frankie, and he is the only one right now with a home run for the Mustangs on the year. He had a home run down at La Junta against Bayfield. Now a courtesy runner. I believe that is courtesy runner is Luke Wolf. Frank Ortega up to the plate can do some damage here. Let's see if he can get into one. As tying run at the plate, but Jay Douglas has not been real consistent here. We'll see if Frankie has taken. That pitch is in there for a strike. That's fine. You got to take, got to make him pitch. As Douglas looks in for the sign and the pitch, and that's going to be upstairs. One ball and one strike to Frank Ortega. He is 1 for 1, hit by a pitch, singled, then walked his last time up. The Mustangs are down 7-3 with the tying run at the plate, and that ball is chopped foul down the third base line. Be one ball now and two strikes to Frankie. Get everybody back into their positions here. See if Frank can put one down the left field line. He's got a lot of room down that left field line. Got kind of a closed stance. We'll see which way he goes with it. And the pitch, and a swing, and a miss. Four, strike three, but the Mustangs get one run on two hits and one error as we go to the bottom of the inning number six with the Mustangs behind 7-3 on Morgan County's B106 and the Eastern Plains Sports Network. The Mustangs get one, but they do leave the bases loaded. It will now be Bodie Wheatley out on the mound for the Mustangs. Charlie Langford over to second. Frank Ortega will now be at shortstop, and Jesse Campa will be at third base. So Evan Robbie, yes, he will come back up. He was at the plate when they had the pickoff at first. See if we can get some numbers here on Jesse Campa here in a minute. As Robbie is 1-for-2, tripled and flied out. And the pitch, and that is in there for a strike. Nice curveball there by Bodie Wheatley. So we play in the bottom of the sixth inning with the Eagles up 7-3. And that pitch is going to be fouled off to the left and out of play. Evens, or it makes it now no balls and two strikes. And the pitch, and that ball is hit hard out into left center field. For the single, so Robbie on. Up to the plate now is Javier Flores. He is 1-for-3, grounded out his first two times up and then singled out to left field. Yes, Flores gets his sign from the head coach down there at third base, and the pitch, and tried to bunt and bunted through it. So trying to get Robbie moved over. And Bodie Wheatley on the bump now for the Mustangs. 7-3 Eagles. Throw over to first, but back safely is Robbie. Flores digs back in. Looks like he wants to bunt one more time here. We'll see if he pulls it back and tries to swing away. Yeah, he does. And that is going to be to the second baseman. On to one and two. Double play by the Mustangs. Nice job out there by Charlie Langford to start that. As that double play goes, four, 6-3, four two outs. That will bring up Bo Heaton. But nice job there by the Mustangs as Charlie Langford started that double play. And the pitch is low and away for ball one. Heaton is 1-for-3, grounded out, flied out, and then singled his last time up. And the pitch in there for a strike, catches the bottom part of the plate. The Mustangs in the top of the seventh will have Jesse Campa, Colin Farley, and David Keller. And the pitch, and that ball is hit out to right field, out to Farley. And Farley comes down with it for out number three. So we will go to the top of the seventh inning. Mustangs, the Eagles get no runs on one hit, nobody left. So we'll go to the top of the seventh inning. Mustangs have work to do here on Morgan County's B106 and the Eastern Plains Sports Network. Down to the last chance here for the Mustangs is Jesse Campa up to the plate. His day on the hill had 80 total pitches. One strikeout, gave up 11 hits and 5 earned runs. Jesse Campa is 1-for-3, doubled his last time up out to left field. So we need some runners here as Zach McVay now on the hill for the Eagles, and that pitch is in there for a strike. See if we can get this game in before any moisture decides it wants to start falling here. An hour and 41 minutes so far. So fairly quick moving game, and that pitch is up and away. Ball one, one ball, one strike. See if the Mustangs can make some more inroads here, and that pitch is going to be popped up down the third base line, and that is going to be taken and dropped. Oh no, he's going to be out. Jesse Campa tried to stretch that into a double. So we're going to give him a single. Is that, well, you know what? That's going to be an error. So Jesse Campa is going to be out. Out at second base. And that brings up Colin Farley. Colin Farley now, one ball and one strike. And strike two, one ball and two strikes. But an error on the shortstop. That will be two errors on Thompson Valley this afternoon. And the pitch, and that's going to be upstairs for ball two. Two balls, two strikes with one out. These two teams will play again tomorrow. We'll have that game for you right here on B106 and the Eastern Plains Sports Network. That ball is fouled straight back. It will be David Keller on deck. Charlie Lankford. That pitch is going to be low. Three balls, two strikes. Colin Farley. David Keller on deck. And the pitch. And that is going to be a swing and a miss. So two down now here as it will be Keller. He is 3 for 3, a double and two singles. So nice day here for David Keller. But down to their last out here as the Mustangs are down 7-3 here in the top of the seventh inning. Nobody on. And two outs. See if he can keep it alive. And that pitch is in there for a strike. Looked like it might have been a little low and outside both, but got the call. And the pitch. And that's going to be hit to the third baseman. He gets it, but falls down. So we'll give Keller a hit on that one. That was a hard hit ball out to the third baseman. Lost his footing, did stop it, but then fell down. So one runner on. It will be Charlie Lankford, 2 for 3, a single, two singles, then a fly out. Wouldn't think Keller would be going too far away. They don't want to be thrown out on the bases. And the pitch. And that is up for ball one. One ball and two strikes. This is Zach McVay who has come in to finish off the game here. Jesse Campa will be, if the Mustangs do not score. And the pitch. And is in there for a strike. Will be the losing pitcher here this afternoon. Kellen Schultz will be the winning pitcher if things don't change. And back in safely is Keller over at first. One ball, one strike, two outs here, top of the seventh. The Mustangs down 7-3. And the pitch, and that is going to be hit out to the shortstop. Oh, off of his glove. There is an error in play. But an error out there by the shortstop. So runners at first and second. That's what we're needing is runners here. Now up to the plate is Levi McCoy. He is 1-for-3, a fly out, a line drive, and then a single. Right off the glove of Evan Robbie out there at shortstop, and that pitch is in there for a strike. Levi down in the count now, no balls and one strike. So we can put it in play here. And the pitch. And that is in there for strike two. Down in the count now, no balls and two strikes is Levi McCoy. And the pitch, and that bounces in, but nice stop there by Jay Douglas behind the plate. It keeps the Keller at second and Lankford at first. But two outs here in the top of the seventh with the Mustangs down 7-3. And the pitch, and that misses outside. Had to wait just a minute. This umpire takes a little bit of time to call a strike, so. Two balls, two strikes. If he likes it, he'll have it. And the pitch. Oh, that was a high, and that was strike three. So the Thompson Valley Eagles will defeat your Fort Morgan Mustangs here this afternoon by a count of 7-3. We will take a 1 minute break and be back with the postgame show here on Morgan County's B106 and the Eastern Plains Sports Network. Well, the Mustangs fall by a count of 7-3 here this afternoon. The postgame show is brought to you by Morgan Community College. MCC is here to make your dreams become a reality for both traditional and non-traditional students. Check them out today at morgancc.edu. Thompson Valley Eagles got on the board first in the second inning with one run. The Mustangs then countered with that in the top of the third with a single run. The Eagles then put two on the board in the bottom of the fourth. Mustangs put one on the board in the top of the fifth, and then Thompson Valley broke it open in the bottom of the fifth with four. Two of those are unearned runs. And then Mustangs put one on the board once again in the top of the sixth inning. They did leave the bases loaded, had two outs, bases loaded, and could not bring anybody else in. And that was their three runs for the Mustangs. They go down 7-3. I had them as three runs on 11 hits, two errors, and 11 left on. Thompson Valley with seven runs, 12 hits, two errors, and four left on. Game time was 1 hour and 48 minutes. The winning pitcher was Kellen Schultz. Losing pitcher today was Jesse Campa. That drops the Mustangs record now to 2-1 in league, and the Thompson Valley Eagles at 2-1. These Thompson Valley Eagles will be in Fort Morgan tomorrow afternoon for the second of this home and away for the in the league. So the Mustangs fall here 7-3 here at Thompson Valley High School. Thanks to Christy Creighton running the boards for me back at the studios today. This has been Brian Nickel. Once again, the final score here from Thompson Valley High School, the Thompson Valley Eagles 7, the Fort Morgan Mustangs 3. You've been listening to Morgan Mustang Baseball on Morgan County's B106 and the Eastern Plains Sports Network.